Hello, my name is David Hannam. I'm the National Treasurer for the British National Party, and today I'm going to give you a general guide to the Treasury Department and the workings within that department. So if you'd follow me this way, please.
Okay, I'm going to give you a general overview of the Treasury Office Department and the general history of the Treasury Department and where we've come from and where we are today. Well, the most notable difference with the party as a whole is, of course, turnover. Back in 2003, all those years ago, we had a annual turnover of just 370,000. In 2008, we had a turnover of 985,000. In 2009, we actually went over 2 million as an annual turnover. Looking at the current figures for 2010, we're going to match that 2 million figure again, I expect, at the end of the year. But of course, with a huge turnover, well, a huge increase in turnover, it's a very good thing, it's a very positive thing, but it does create other problems. And the most notable problem that I identified when I took over the National Treasurer's job back in February or March was the fact that there was a lack of control and infrastructure within the party Treasury Department, within the actual financial structure or infrastructure of the party. The lack of control was most apparent prior to the general election, throughout the general election, but most notably it became really apparent after the general election. At one point during the general election, we actually thought we were going to come out of the election relatively in the black. In fact, that is exactly what the party believed we had done. The scary fact was, when we came out of the election, we realised that due to a lack of real financial control, we'd incurred expenditure we didn't even know about, which basically means a good number of individuals can incur expenditure on behalf of the BNP, and the party didn't even know about it. That's a horrendous lack of financial control, which has really cost us. However, it has been sorted. It's been sorted because we've now implemented a very, very stringent and a very, very hard, very difficult, nonetheless, process, but a very difficult and stringent purchase order system, whereby only a very few people are actually allowed to incur expenditure on behalf of this party. So we're never, ever going to be in a position again whereby some individuals or a few well-meaning individuals can actually incur expenditure on behalf of this party and cost us. So that's been sorted. The lack of controls is the most key feature to what I'm going to talk about today, which is why eventually we needed, as the turnover increased, we then had to progress to a bigger office. Now, I say a bigger office, it's actually smaller than my old office, but like most people in the party, you know, this party is a small party in the big scheme of things. I used to work from a bedroom / office from home. Those days have gone, unfortunately. We had to take on, with a higher turnover, we had to get serious. So we've taken on this extremely cheap office, which we rent per month, and we have one assistant working with me, which is absolutely essential, because as we progress in turnover, we have to increase the controls. As well as increasing the controls, that also means maintaining our accounts daily. Not weekly, not monthly, not 6-monthly, or even horrendously, as has happened in the past, annually, which has led to late submission of accounts. Now, what we do in this office is we have accounts up to date by the day. So we examine all the income streams on a daily basis, and we examine all our expenditures on a day-by-day basis. So controls within the party have escalated hugely, and it's absolutely essential. The state of the party's current finances is precarious. I'm not going to lie to you. Any party that comes out of a major general election is going to be somewhat financially bruised. Actually, we wouldn't be doing too bad if not for these horrendous court cases. And I can tell you now, they are hitting us very, very bad. And it's a very deliberate attack. These things are accidental. They know exactly what they're doing, and they're hitting the party very hard financially with all these court cases. So we do need help. We need help financially, it is true, we need those donations, we need that, otherwise we can't exist as a party. That's what they're trying to do. However, we also help need on another front. This is a young Treasury Department. It's a new Treasury Department, it's a new office. We have new controls in place. But we do have a huge skills list in this party of people who actually have a long experience in the financial sector. And what I would like to see as a Treasurer is I'd like to see us pooling our resources, our best heads in the party, coming together and figuring out how we can improve things. So what I would say to anyone watching this who is in the financial sector, within the party, or even outside the party, by all means get in touch with us, get in touch with the Treasury Department, and we'll go through. If you've got ideas that can help improve the party's financial infrastructure, we will definitely listen. Turnover has increased, exponentially it's increased. It's it's a great turnover. However, as I said, there are inherent problems with any huge turnover. It wouldn't be too much of a problem if our turnover had increased gradually over the years. But what happened is since 2007 December to 2010, our turnover has simply just gone from there to there. It's a huge, huge increase. And of course, problems kicked in with that, lack of controls. We've now sorted those lack of controls. They will not happen again. To summarise, current finances are precarious, but we do need the help of all you good donors out there. And again, I will make a call. Anybody who has any help to offer the party, please come forward. Well, and that's it. Well, I hope you've enjoyed a general overview that I've provided to you. I would like to end by saying a big, big, big thank you to all the people who give to this party month on month on month. We couldn't do this without you. You're a very dedicated donor, loyal donor base, and I really do appreciate it, and the party appreciates it. So thank you very much.